Reviews back again, kind of in literary corner, a bit further down the library, all the books and everything. It's where I listen to all my bits and bobs and everything else. Sit up straight, Tom. Sit up erect. I'm sitting here erect now. It's nice though, isn't it? It's a bit of change, you know, a bit of a difference. Got these for some point in the near future. The old St. Sixtus and the St. Bernardus and whatever, all amongst the different books and whatever. But we're going kind of along the ecclesiastical sections and that, and we're going to, I think it started off in this brewery as part of an abbey or something like that. But they've got their own ancient well and everything there, and anyway, it's Saint Peter's, or St. Peter's. We say Saint, yeah. It is a gluten-free. I'm going to do a couple of gluten-free ones, because they've got a G-free, which is a gluten-free beer, and they've got a dark G-free. Yeah. Gluten-free is, you've got all the celiacs and amnesiacs and dizzy yaks and aphrodizzy yaks and all sorts of other dizzy yaks. But no, seriously, celiacs and that. Gluten intolerance can be quite serious, but also some people that ain't gluten intolerant, you know, think that it does good to not have it in the way, you know, not have it in your diet. Personally, I don't know. I think if you're intolerant to it, then that's fair enough, but otherwise, you know, you should have a bit of this and a bit of that in your diet and that, you know. But there you go. What do I know? Big fat me. Let's open it with the old BB. A lovely, whoa, that's quite fizzy. The old lovely the crow and the key there. Crows, throughout kind of time and everything, have always been a symbol of gatekeepers and guardians and all that sort of stuff, you know. So they'll be a gatekeeper or guardian of something, of a key of some sort. That's why crows at, ravens, I should say. That's why there's ravens at, it's right up at the top of that, look, at Tower of London and that. I've already gone off, anyway, I'm sorry. Don't you miss my rambling, my complete meanderings and everything else. Look, let's get excited. Are you pleased to see me, or is that a froth in your pocket? Let's quickly read it before the froth goes crazy. Have I got my glasses? Don't laugh at my glasses. Don't laugh. They're like 50 pence in the shop ones. I refuse. I just breathed in as I took that. I refused to go and buy a pair, so I've got these, look like a school teacher now. Cool. A clean, crisp, a clean, crisp, gluten-free ale. I've usually found that gluten-free ones are not all that nice. Gluten-free ale with a Pilsner-style lager finish. And aromas of citrus and mandarin from American Amarillo hops, which is cool, I like Amarillo. brewed with skill and patience in Britain's finest small brewery. Fair enough. So it says on there, like a big thing with the line for the wheat, I suppose that's a... kind of doodah, the sign for not you know, celiac and everything else. Coeliac, says on there. Is that East Bull Celiac? Gluten free, you know, UK license, it's got a license number. Historic notes and things like that. Has been for 700 years and all that, cobblers. Then know your limits and the lady going like that with the ponytail and everything else. St. Peter's Hall and all that, right. So basically there's nothing much about why it's celiac or about any of the ingredients or anything else. I'd be guessing that you're talking kind of sorghum or something like that, you know, that they're brewing with sorghum or something. I don't know, you know. But let's pour it and see what we got. I don't imagine it's bowl conditioned. I don't know. It could be. It doesn't seem like it. It seems like gas, you know. Usually when you see gas, you can even hear it. When it's, usually when it's kind of not, is that going to go there? No, down there. When it's, you know, false carbonated and that, it sounds like gas. Right, usually. But that's what it looks like going through. That's pretty, pretty. Kind of bulby head and all that going on. Again, I don't know how much of that. It doesn't look like an E405 type of head. You know, they usually, this kind of like a stabiliser and thickener and all that. And it usually leaves a Bart Simpson-y kind of dipple to it. You can kind of pick up with your hand. That's looks natural, looks good. The beer, the drink looks natural. So, looks natural, natural. Let's have a sniffed. Smells quite delightful. Smells, it smells, as they say, of little mandarins and things like that. It smells of little mandarins, zest and things off the mandarin especially. But a little bit of the fruit as well and a bit of the pith. Little fistless things. Fistless, I always do that. Come buy them, try them. Little fistless, like tiny little things like that. They look a bit like a cross between a mandarin and a tomato. Tomato, sorry. And they've got little crispy leaves all wrapped around it like that. They're really nice. They're expensive, but they're really nice. Something you've got to try once, you know. Got their own individual taste and that, so it's worth trying. It's not like, was it, quail's eggs. And you go, all the cook chefs and that, oh, quail's eggs. Mm. And you pay like, I don't know, 50p each for these little eggs about that big. Or more than that, probably. And then, they're not much better than chicken eggs, because there's not a lot of difference. Someone will go, what are you on about? No, it's not. It's like, there's a difference between something like duck eggs and that. It's got a richer sort of flavour in that, you know. But, you know, chicken eggs and quail eggs. No, it's a, sorry, I've gone off. Let's have another sniffed. Very light malts and that. Very light sort of edges to them. It smells a little bit slightly corny, slightly some kind of breakfast cereal, sort of cornflakes, rice crispies, slight bit of that edging in there, and then sort of dry grain sort of things. And it's something that I'm not sure about. Something slightly. Slightly kind of like peanut shells, you know, the actual shells of peanuts when you pop them, it smells like that. And something a bit awkward, a bit, I don't know. Anyway, let's dive in, because sometimes smells tell lies. So give it a little twist, give it a live enough, have a sniff, and then don't breathe in as you're doing it, but. First notes, first impressions I'm getting is a nice little fruity notes. Nice, delicate, as they say, lager taste to it. So nice little delicate notes, nice little lager sort of taste to it. It's actually quite nice. There is an horrible little putty note in the background that's on the tongue, just coming in really late. It's a dry sort of thing, but it's a kind of an unwelcome dry. It's like a bit of a copper coin in the mouth sort of dry. And whenever all that sweet fruit goes away, and it's a lovely little sweet, just a almost like an opal fruit sweetness, like a little sweet but still citrusy taste, which is really delicious. When that goes away, you're kind of left with a long distant finish that is that's slightly coppery, metallic-y in it. Blood. Must be the iron. It's kind of like an iron. Maybe it's just they've got iron in the salts, but if you've ever bled into your mouth or something like that, I mean, I used to be a boxer and all that business, and I've tasted blood a lot, you know, me own, not anyone else's. And you kind of have got that slightly salty but iron-rich sort of thing going on. And same with certain iron tablets and things like that. Yeah, rather than a copper finish, it's like iron. It's like, you know, like licking iron. But that's only a tiny bit. Most of it is pretty good. I would say, if you're not gluten intolerant or celiac or whatever, I would say, yeah, you know, it's all right. You know, it's not bad. But if you're gluten intolerant, you know, if you're, as I say, celiac, or I hope I've got the right words for that, that one is quite nice. It's quite nice. So I'd say bum, 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 bum. Buy it, try it, and like it. Without a doubt. It's not bad at all. I'd love to know from St. Peter's. It is nice. I mean, even if you're not celiac, it's nice. But it's just that weird little iron note coming in at the end that's a bit of a party crasher, a bit of a gate crasher. It's kind of like the parents coming in at the end of the party. Click, all the lights go on, turn the music off, right, on you go everyone, thank you. Yeah, I didn't swear. So it just went right. Anyway, good luck, everyone. Good fortunes, good health, and take care of each other. And I'll see you all soon. See you in the next one. Don't be late. I will start you here. Cheers. Bye. And it's how you can face